Hello, hello, hello. Good morning, everyone. Hope everyone's doing great. If this is your first time visiting my channel, my name is Wana, and every week I try to share important content on strategies I'm implementing in my personal life to increase my personal finance and also build wealth. So, if you're new, thank you very much. For my subscribers, I do appreciate you all. Thank you. Without you, I wouldn't be doing this. So you give me the motivation every day to get up and, you know, share this content. So my topic today is for those who are currently interested in personal finance and how to improve things. So I'm going to discuss a few things that you need to know in terms of personal finance basics for beginners. So if you're advanced, then this video is not for you. You can check other videos I have. However, if you're new to personal finance or you're trying to improve your personal financial situation, then this might be very helpful to you because these are things that I'm currently implementing in my life to improve my personal finance. So just to get something clear, I am not an attorney. I am not a tax professional. I am not a counselor. My daytime job, I'm a banker and I'm also an entrepreneur. I have multiple businesses that produce, you know, small amount of income for me, but I'm trying to build them. So I'm just a random guy on YouTube, just trying to share knowledge and information with people. So let's jump right into it. So the first thing you want to do is you want to decide, okay? You have to make that decision that, you know what, where I'm currently at is not where I want to be, okay? If you're sick and tired of where you are right now, which is how I felt a few months ago, is, you know what, I need to change something. So you want to invest in yourself and make sure that you get the right knowledge, okay, to be able to improve your current position. So this is what I'm currently implementing in my life to get myself to the next level. So number one, you want to create a budget, okay? When you create a budget is like a blueprint. It's like a plan for you, all right? So having a budget is the first step. You gotta have a budget. A budget tells you how much income's coming in, how much money is going out, and what's left at the end of the month. All right, if you don't have this, then the battle is already lost. So you have to sit down one day, you know, tune out all distractions, turn off Facebook, turn off everything, turn off, you know, your cell phone, and just sit down and focus and analyze how much money you're bringing in, how much you're bringing in from your paycheck or from your side hustle, whatever. And list all your expenses, and then you subtract your expenses from your income, and that tells you how much money you have left over, which is basically your cash flow, and that tells you where to begin. So you have to have a baseline where you're starting off from. So you have to create a budget, all right? And then just give me 1 second, let me just use my glasses here to see, because I made some notes, so I really don't want to miss things, okay? So by creating budgets, you'll be able to analyze your data and see where you're wasting money. So if you're wasting money on subscriptions, then it might be time to, you know, cancel the subscriptions or try to negotiate with your provider to see if you can get a lower rate without losing any of your options, okay? So you have to start with a budget. Number two, you have to increase your income, all right? So after you do your budget and you see that maybe at the end of the month you're left with $100, okay, or $50, or maybe you're negative, then it's time to get into action and increase your income. So increasing your income, there are different ways for you to do that. You can get online with the internet today. You can get into affiliate marketing. You can start your own agency to become a social media agency where you can run ads for companies. You can start a service business, all right? You can start doing Uber, rideshare, or Lyft. Okay, you can start doing Uber Eats, you can do DoorDash. Okay, I'm not sponsored by any of these companies, but I have dabbled into some of them just to increase my income. All right, so, you know, I used to do Uber to supplement my income. All right, but because of the health crisis, I stopped doing it because I don't want to put myself in a tough situation. So that's why I stopped doing it. But the revenue I got from Uber was able to help me fund my other projects. All right, even though I have a full-time job, I was still doing Uber to try to generate more income so that I could funnel that income into my other businesses, okay, to build you know, for advertising, for marketing, for, you know, tools that I need for my business. So you have to increase your income. Number three, you have to create an emergency fund. Okay, did you know that most Americans today don't have access to $1,000 in, you know, if they have an emergency? So your goal right now should be have an emergency fund of at least $1,000, preferably $2,000. Okay, you can put that money into a high yield money market account or high yield savings account that you can earn maybe 1%. That money is not an investment. So when people say, oh well, you're only getting 1%, yes, 1% is better than zero. All right, so that 1% you're getting, you're just parking the money there as an insurance policy. All right, we all have insurance on our cars, we all have health insurance, we all have life insurance. Okay, so that money should be like an insurance policy for you. So when your car breaks down, or your fridge breaks down, or you have to, you know, buy something or get something done, you know, that will require more money, then you have that safety net. So you want to create an emergency fund, you know, of at least $1,000. All right, number two, you want to start paying off debt. All right, we are so saddled with so much debt today. We have students loan, we have credit cards, we have home equity loans, we have a mortgage, we have a car payment, and we have a boat payment, we have a skip. We have so many payments that's sucking away money from us. All right, but that's the lifestyle that everybody falls into. We all fall into this category of, you know, we earn money and we spend everything we have. Okay, you have to change that mindset. I'm guilty of that as well, and I'm changing how I'm handling money. You have to have a better relationship with money, but it starts with you having discipline and following certain strategies. So all what I'm listening to you are things that I have learned from people, okay, that have made it, and I'm applying it to my life. And that's why I'm sharing this with you. All right, so you want to start paying off debt on a schedule. So you can list, or there are different ways for you to pay off debt. You can go on YouTube and, you know, and search, or you can go on Google. There are different resources out there available for you to be able to apply, okay, and strategies for you to pay down debt. And then finally, you want to invest in income producing assets. Okay, so you want to income in businesses, okay, not just buying stuff. You know, I know some people spend time researching a flat screen TV that depreciates. They spend thousands of dollars on a flat screen TV that doesn't do anything for you except sit on your counter, on your bureau, and collect dust, and then dumbs you down. Why not take that $4,000 or $1,000 and start a side business, start a gig, all right? So in my case, I'm investing in, I have an Amazon FBA store that I'm investing money into products that I'm selling on Amazon, and Amazon handles everything for me. So that's another income producing asset for me. So I'm tapping into Amazon, I'm tapping into technology, and I'm tapping into all the resources and the backing that Amazon has to provide. So this is how you need to think, all right? So I hope this meets you well. I hope you enjoy my content. I know this is kind of like a serious content today, but I try to keep it lively, and I hope I'm doing a great job, you know, at this. So I'm not a professional YouTuber, I'm just a regular guy just like you, but I'm so passionate about helping people and also helping myself, you know, with all these strategies. So if you love this content, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up, hit the notification bell so you get notified of my new content, and also please subscribe to my channel. And for all my new subscribers, I want to thank you so much for being here. Please share my content. Check my channel for other content as well. And please leave me comments so I'll know what topics you're interested in, so I can do more for you guys and, you know, learn some more as well. Okay, thank you for coming on this journey with me. And until next time, I'll see you then. Thank you. Bye-bye.